Comfort Melon from KIU says, hi, MC Casmir, I'm Comfort. Send my regards to Oscar, Henry, Martin, Judith, and others. You love the show. Asante sana, Comfort Melon, and shout out to everybody watching from KIU. Now, last weekend, we had an opportunity to hear from Miss IUEA. Today, I bring you the king, Mr. IUEA. Let's find out what makes him outstanding.
My name is Milton Mwila. I'm from Zambia, and I'm the current king, the Mr. IUEA 2016-2017. I'm pursuing a Bachelor of Science in Civil Engineering, and I'm in my second year. My lifestyle is easy, it's fun, and it's also amazing. Well, 2 years back, I was at the University of Zambia, and I had contested in a similar pageant, and I happened to win. I was Mr. Unza 2014-2015. So when I came to Uganda at International University of East Africa, I said, why not give it a try? So I love challenges. So for me, it was more of just a challenge. Yeah. Well, what motivated me in the first place, 2 years ago, I participated in a similar pageant. I was at the University of Zambia and I participated in Mr. Unza and I happened to win. So when I came to International University of East Africa, I thought, why not give it a try? So for me, it's more of a challenge, and I tried it and thank God I won. Well, there were quite a number, because in the first place, talking about talent, I wasn't sure of what I'm going to do, because these guys, like everyone who was participating, guys knew how to dance, and I wasn't like the best dancer. So I was trying to find something that I could do that is not very common amongst the other contestants. So the talent for me was a bit of a challenge. And of course, getting everything in place was also a challenge, because we had like 8 categories. So getting everything in place was quite a challenge, yeah. Well, I did poetry. Yes. Yes, I'm a budding poet. Money is the knife that sliced us apart. Son of a director and I of a janitor. No judge would risk that job for toilet floors well cleaned by the skills and tics and expertise of a janitor. It's as if the justice system has been tailored, defined and aligned to favor the so-called rich and the money bags. My tragedy began back when I was in high school. Being able to read, write, memorize debt equations and laws, and to my teachers, I was cool. Among my peers, I was looked at as the exact opposite of cool. I was an alien. Imagine. Just imagine the feeling of being an outsider inside my classroom among my peers. I gave in to peer pressure. Before long, I was falling for everything that came along, juggling books, hooks, looks, drugs, and alcohol. I was living my dream. Until one day, the feeling of being wanted, the feeling of being desired, the feeling of belonging that gave me a sense of patriotism was no more. My best friend and I were tried for substance abuse. My best friend was acquitted and I convicted. You see, there comes a time in life when life unfolds in an unpredictable manner, but always in favor of the haves than the have-nots. How then do we sit back and fold our arms and believe that the system is just, when the word J-U-S-T-I-C-E, justice, is defined by how fat one's account is? Whistleblowing on players of corruption implemented by the perpetrators to create the flow. It is clear that the system screwers know the name of the game and determine the rules of the game in this unjust society. Well, I play Scrabble, so I just love words in the first place. And I've always thought I could do poetry or spoken word something, but I had never really tried it until the recent contest. That's the reason why I said it was a challenge for me, because I had to find something that moves me from my comfort zone, and poetry did it for me, so yeah.
Well, my biggest competitors in this competition were the two gentlemen who actually later on made us first runners-up and second runners-up. Their names are Danny and Hassan. For Danny, he's a professional model already in Uganda, so he had everything on point. He knew what he knew the catwalk very well, and he already knew just how to do this thing. While for Hassan, in the first place, he was the best dressed. That's my judgment. He had the best clothes, and then he also participated in this same competition last year. So he basically knew what he had to do. So that's the reason why they were. Well, what I think really made me outstanding was the fact that I was very confident. And I was able to create a rapport with the audience in the few minutes that I was on stage, because I would make sure that I take my time and work very well. And of course, the cheering made the judges somehow give me more points. And also the talent that I did, I was the only one who did spoken word art, and somehow that made me stand out. Well, what I love about IUEA in the first place is that IUEA is the only university in Uganda which has students from over 40 countries. So I love the diversity that you find in International University of East Africa, unlike other universities. And then apart from that, we have very good classrooms, of course, and the lecture to student ratio is very good. You are in a class which is well air conditioned and everything. Yeah, it's amazing. Well, what I think about the beauty pageants in the country, on the contrary, instead of spoiling the creativity, I feel it enhances the creativity. Well, I spend my free time with my girlfriend, and also I love reading and playing Scrabble. Well, if I were not Mr. IUEA, I would do a lot of things like play Scrabble, continue playing Scrabble, and also try to build my new talent of spoken word art. I'm trying to build myself as a spoken word artist, and also just generally concentrate on my studies. I do believe in finding real love at campus, because I think as it is now, I found the love of my life, and we happen to be both at campus, and it's interesting. Yeah, I do believe in it so much. Well, what I wish to do for IUEA as the current king of IUEA and the face of IUEA is I wish to market the university, because my university is awesome. Well, in the next 10 years, I see myself as a politician. Well, for those of you who want to be like me, those who want to be Mr. IUEA, you want to be a leader, all I can say is you just need to believe in yourself and stay focused. When you decide and believe that it's going to happen, then it's going to happen for you. Because when you decide, you're going to work it in that particular line. You do what you have to do and do it right.
It's about that time we squeeze out some juice and share some Lugambo in campus juice. But before that, a big shout out to my stylist, Akram Kasozi. Things are getting tougher and tougher ever since Makerere University has been closed down. Now, according to the tabloids, the government has also stopped the staff of Makerere University from taking trips on behalf of the university. You know, usually lecturers and administration usually travel around the world on the ticket of the university, but ever since it's been closed down, no more trips on behalf of the university. And of course, I've been told, even the lecturers have been told to go back home, apart from those working in the office of the vice chancellor or maybe the secretary and the bursar of the university. He's one of the students of Makerere University, and I just bumped into him. How are you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm all right. What's your name?
I'm Ezra. Thanks for that show.
Thank you so much, Ezra. Now, the university has been closed down. I know everyone is at home very bored. What do you think about the entire saga?
I think the lecturers have a reason why the university was closed. First of all, they are saying the government has not paid their arrears, which I believe it's true. But to me, I think Makerere has so many issues whereby the government needs to come up with a committee to investigate all those issues so that those issues are resolved once and for all.
Now, you as a student, how has it affected you, and what are you doing this time now that you're free from school?
We were supposed to have started our exams, yeah. But you see now the university is closed. So it means that we cannot study. We are at home now cheering. We have got nothing to do. So we are calling upon the government to really look into this issue and open our campus. We want to go back to campus and study.
Away from Makerere University, Mbeya University of Science and Technology is also striking. Now, students are against the retake policy that if you fail a paper or two papers, you pay over 200,000 shillings to sit for those papers. That is where a lot of money in Mbeya University. I mean, Usually in other universities, I think you pay like 20,000, 30,000, but how can you pay 200,000 shillings for a retake? That is more like paying for functional fees of a semester. Indeed, my university, I agree with you guys, you should strike. If it means me joining you next week, I'll probably come through. I would like to remind each one of you how much I appreciate your time, and if you have any events happening in your campus, simply inbox me on our page campus101-official. I'll definitely reply to you. I'll definitely come through for your events. Otherwise, like our motto says, because we love campus and we are Campus 101. My name is Casmir. Have a blessed weekend.